Good morning. Happy Lord's Day to everyone. For the past 11 Sundays, we have been focusing on the Word of God in line with our theme, Rooted in the Word. And we have been studying passages from Psalms 119. So this psalm, as I mentioned before, is the longest chapter in the Bible. 176 verses, and this psalm, the author of the psalm, glorifies the Word of God and the author of the Word of God. Truly, the Bible is one of God's greatest gifts to each one of us. The Word is a gracious gift of God, the source of the fullness of life. And for the past 11 Sundays, by the way, Psalm 119, as I mentioned before, is an acrostic, 22 stanzas representing the 22 letters of the Hebrew alphabet. Each stanza consists of 8 lines, and each line, the first letter of each line, starts with that particular Hebrew alphabet. And we have been looking at all the benefits that we can get from the Word of God. The Word of God gives joy to the heart. If we will review the past messages, the Word of God gives power to overcome sin. The Word of God gives strength to the soul. The Word of God gives hope. The Word of God reassures during pain. The Word of God feeds the hungry spirit. The Word of God gives light. The Word of God gives understanding. The Word of God directs to wisdom. The Word of God gives comfort. Last Sunday, Pastor June led us in the meditation of how the Word of God soothes the discouraged heart. For the 12th of this series, we look at stanza number 21, representing the 21st letter of the Hebrew alphabet called Shin. And the focus of these 8 verses, verses 161 to 168, the Word of God gives peace. The Word of God gives peace, kapayapaan. And everyone needs peace. Peace is very important. Maraming mga kaguluhan sa mundo. Maraming mga kaguluhan sa ating buhay. And we are anxious and worried about many things. In fact, it is said that anxiety is the number one mental health disorder. Yung labis na pagkabalisa. We worry about a lot of things. Now, what are the things that you worry about? Ano ba yung kadalasan na pinagkakabalisahan natin, mga agam-agam natin? Tungkol sa pera. Well, ayon sa pag-aaral po ng mga dalibhasa, tatlong bagay daw. No, they made a survey, tatlong bagay ang focus ng worry of most people. Tama, number one ay pera. Number two ay kwarta. Number three ay salapi. Talaga ngayon ang mga kinagkakaabalahan ng mga tao ngayon. Ewan ko, baka hindi naman sa KBCF ginawa yung survey. Baka doon sa kabilang church. And then, sorry. So, pero we worry about so many things. And number one is about money. But there are other things that we worry about. We worry about our health. No? Naku, baka ako magkasakit. Baka yung mga malulubhang sakit ay dumapo sa akin. We worry about our relationships, our marriages. No? Sa mga single, naku, sino kaya mapapangasawa ko? O may mapapangasawa pa kaya ako? So, and mga married naman, we worry about our relationship with our spouses. We worry about parenting, our children. We worry about different threats around us. We worry about our weight. We worry about so many things in our lives. We worry about our jobs. We worry about our security. Kaya talagang kailangan ng bawat isa sa atin ang kapayapaan. Peace. The Word of God gives peace. Many of us are familiar with the Hebrew word for peace called shalom. But many are not familiar with the meaning of shalom. The real meaning of this word is wholeness. Pagiging buo. Kasi yung word na peace, minsan parang mababaw. At minsan, palasak na. Nawawala na lang talagang meaning niya. But the real meaning of the word shalom is wholeness. According to a dictionary of expository dictionary of Bible words, shalom means completeness, health, welfare, state of harmony, and wholeness. Napakalalim ng ibig sabihin ng shalom that we have translated to English as peace. Kaya yung pagbati, especially the Hebrews, the Jews, when they greet one another, shalom, napakalalim doon. It is a very deep greeting, wishing another of all the wonderful experiences of life with God. Ganun kalalim yung greeting na shalom. Peace is not just the mere absence of conflict. Minsan yun ang mababaw na pagtingin natin pag sinabing peace. Pag merong peace, walang gulo. Pero that is just one aspect of peace. Hindi lang yung negative aspect na walang gulo. Ano naman ang meron? Well, peace is so deep. Hindi lang yung absence of conflict or absence of troubles, but there is the completeness, wholeness, health, harmony in relationships. Yun ang peace. A story has been told of a king, no, isang hari, who commissioned artists to paint a picture of peace. Maraming mga sumali doon sa contest. Kanya-kanyang painting. But pagdating sa dulo, dalawa na lang yung finalist. Yung isang painting, it is a beautiful painting of a serene lake. No, merong mga mountains, tapos merong sky na very blue with fluffy clouds. Talagang very peaceful yung tanawin. Yung kabilang entry ay meron ding mountains pero rugged mountains. Tapos cloudy skies. Nagsisimula ng umulan. Even with lightning. May mga kakidlat-kidlat pa. Tapos merong isang malaking waterfall na talagang ang lakas ng bagsak ng tubig. At first glance, parang hindi siya picture of peace. But upon closer look, sa ilalim ng waterfall, merong isang maliit na bush at merong pugad. At dun sa pugad, nandun yung ibon. Kasama niya yung kanyang mga inakay. Very peaceful. Sa gitna nung kaguluhan sa paligid. Of course, that painting won the contest. Sabi daw nung king, peace is not the absence of noise, it's not the absence of hardships or troubles. Peace is staying calm in spite of all these troubles around us. Ganun kalalim ang peace. Hindi lang yung walang kaguluhan, kundi tinataglay mo anuman ang nasa iyong kapaligiran. So, in this world of troubles, the Word gives true peace. I say true peace because there is such a thing as false peace. But true peace comes from the Word of God. So, how can we experience true peace? From the passage that we have read this morning, I would like to share with you five ways that we can truly experience this real, true, and lasting peace. And if you will look at your bulletins, gumamit din ako ng acrostic. Para madaling tandaan, P-E-A-C-E. How can we experience true peace? First, we must perceive the brokenness of man and the world. Perceive, not just being able to see things. When you say perceive, mas malalim na pananaw sa mga bagay-bagay. The psalmist was a realist. If we will read the whole psalm, he looks at the things around him, what is happening, what was happening around him with the eyes of a realist. No, makatotohanan siya. Na, kaya binabanggit niya sa buong psalm, yung mga kaguluhan, yung persecution, yung mga trials, yung mga kahirapan na kanyang dinaranas, especially from those who do not respect the Word of God. He was a realist. And if we want to experience true peace, we must be realistic. We must perceive that we live in a broken world. We are broken people living in a broken world. Magsimula tayo doon sa actual condition natin. As a counselor, I've encountered so much brokenness in people. And I think, makatotohanan sa atin, we may be presenting an atmosphere or image of joy na everything is okay. Pag nagkumustahan tayo, nagkamayan tayo, kumusta ka? Okay lang. Pero deep within, we are experiencing troubles, hardships, problems, brokenness. And if we look around us, we observe people. We observe the lives of other people. We read the newspapers. We hear the news. The world is full of brokenness. We are broken people living in a broken world. We must be able to perceive that. Hindi pwede na tayo ay nagbubulag-bulagan na pretending everything is okay. Pretending na ayos lang ang lahat when in fact, hindi. One of the kinds of people that God rejects in the Bible or condemns in the Bible are those who pretend, or the false prophets who pretend that everything is okay when they are not. In the book of Jeremiah, God condemns the false prophets because they dress the wound of my people as though it were not serious. Peace, peace, they say, when there is no peace. No? The reality is there was no peace. There was sin all around them. There was idolatry. There was rebellion to the Word of God. But the false prophets were saying, okay lang yan. Peace, peace, when there is no peace. In the book of Ezekiel, it repeats the same theme. Because they lead my people astray, saying, peace, when there is no peace. And because when a flimsy wall is built, they cover it with whitewash. The walls of society, the walls of families were flimsy, napakahina. But they ignore those facts. They say, they cover it with whitewash. They were not living in reality. They were turning a blind eye to the brokenness of man and the brokenness of this world. But we must accept we are broken people. And it all started when sin entered the world. When sin entered the world, there was that brokenness of man. Noong nagkasala ang una nating magulang, si Adan at si Eva, doon pumasok ang lahat ng brokenness. If peace is wholeness, if shalom is wholeness, ang kabaliktaran noon ay brokenness. Brokenness because of sin. And then there was conflict between man and himself. between man and his fellow man, between man and God, conflict even between man and nature. Mababasa natin sa Genesis chapter 3, when man sinned, it all started with shalom, perfect shalom. And then sin came in and all the brokenness occurred in different aspects, in different areas. Man against self, man against God, and even man against nature. And because of the sin of man, there are these emotional struggles. We struggle with these negative emotions within us. And these negative emotions war against ourselves, and it is the cause of war against man, against his fellow man, even the enmity between man and God, and even man's destroying nature. These emotional struggles occurred when man sinned. First, there was pride. There was pride when man wanted to be equal with God. No? Napakaganda na nga ng pagkakalikha sa kanila ng Diyos, pero gusto pa nilang pantayan ang Diyos. There was that pride. And so man sinned because of this desire caused by pride. And when they sinned, nandun na ngayon yung guilt. Nasira na yung relationship, the perfect relationship between our first parents and God. Doon nagsimulang nasira. And when God was looking for them, nagtago sila dahil nandun na yung negative fear. And they covered themselves. Bakit? Dahil nahihiya sila. Pumasok na yung shame. Pumasok na yung shame. And then, nandun na yung alienation. Alienation sa isa't isa, alienation from God, nandun na yung loneliness. And then, nandun yung inferiority. Napakataas ng estado ng tao sa pagkakalikha ng Diyos, pero bumaba. Bumaba sa kanyang sariling pananaw, yung mga ating self-esteem, yung ating self-dignity, at bumaba yung ating pananaw sa ating kapwa. And ultimately, nandun din yung anger. No? Instead of repenting, instead of trying to make amends with God, men continued to sin and to rebel against God. Nandun yung sin of, or emotion, negative emotion of anger. So, it's the reality. We live in a broken world, and we ourselves are broken people. If we want to talk about peace, let's start with who we are or where we are. We must perceive our own brokenness and the brokenness of this world. But praise be to God. He has given us ways to be able to recover and to experience the true shalom that was His intention from the very start. How do we experience this peace? After seeing the reality, secondly, letter E, we must establish allegiance to God's word. We must be faithful to God's words. First, we must fear God rather than man. Sabi nung psalmist, rulers persecute me without cause. Why were the authorities persecuting this psalmist? Well, they say the real cause of the persecution is because he adheres to the word of God. And they do not honor the word of God. So it was a persecution because of his faith. Rulers persecute me without cause, but my heart trembles at your word. Sinong inuuna niya? Yes, there are authorities in our lives. Different kinds of authorities. Ang tanong, who gets the allegiance in your life? Sino ang nasusunod? Tao o Diyos? Well, for the psalmist, the question has been answered. My heart trembles at your word. Even persecution could not distract him from his allegiance to the word of God. The apostles, when they were persecuted, they were being punished for their faith, at pinagbawalan sila. Huwag nyo nang ipapangaral. Yung salita ng Diyos na yan, ng inyong Diyos. Huwag nyo nang ipapangaral si Jesus Christ. What did they reply? They said, we must obey God rather than men. That is true allegiance to the Word of God. Another way that we can demonstrate allegiance to the Word of God is to rejoice in the Word. Yung salita ng Diyos, hindi parusa, hindi pahirap, hindi burden. The Word of God is a blessing. So we can rejoice in the Word of God. The psalmist says in verse 162, I rejoice in your promise like one who finds great spoil. He considers the Word of God as a treasure. Yun ang ibig sabihin nung like finding great spoil. It means a treasure. No? Napakahalagang treasure na kanyang natuklasan. Do you still recall when we were studying the parables? We talk about the parable of the pearl of great price. We talk about the parable of the precious treasure hidden, no, in the field. Nung natagpuan nung mga nakakita sa kanila, they were filled with joy, no? Kagalakan. Sa Word of God, we find joy. In the promises of God, people have been counting the promises of God in the Bible. At tinitinan ko iba't iba mga references, iba-iba yung ano, iba-iba yung bilang nila. But, somebody counted, Dr. Everett R. Storms of Ontario, Canada, sabi niya, there are 7,487 promises from God to man in the Bible. Napakaraming mga pangako ng Diyos. At kapag ang Diyos ang nangako, of course, magagalak tayo. Pwede nating panghawakan. The Word of God gives joy. We rejoice in the Word. A few weeks ago, Beth and I, we had a seminar in Mindoro, and we stayed doon sa guest house ng isang mission agency, and we encountered mga missionaries, foreign missionaries from the Summer Institute of Linguistics. Ito yung mga missionaries, mga ano sila, foreigners, mga puti. And they translate the Word of God from the original language to yung native dialect ng mga tao doon. Salita ng mga katutubo. And we were talking with them. And ano lang kami, na-impress kami sa kanila. Because itong mga ano to eh, mga galing sila sa mayamang bansa. Mga they have experienced comfort. Pero they are staying there, spending years of their lives doon sa bundok, kasama yung mga tribu, tribal people. And what are they doing? They are translating the Bible doon sa native dialect. Napakahirap na kanilang ginagawa. Napakalayo doon sa kanilang dating buhay. But you know what we noticed about them? Nag-uumapaw na joy. Talagang tuwang-tuwa sila na yung salita ng Diyos na itatranslate at naiintindihan ng mga tao. At kapag nabasa ng mga tao sa kanilang sariling dialect, tuwang-tuwa yung mga tao. Talagang nangingibabaw na naramdaman namin sa kanila the joy that they have in the Word of God. Pangatlong paraan that we can show allegiance to the Word is to hold on to the truth and reject lies. Because the Word of God is truth. At anumang kontra sa Word of God, kasinungalingan. At kung talagang tapat ka sa salita ng Diyos, you hold on to the truth and you reject the lies. Sabi ng psalmist, verse 163, I hate and abhor falsehood, but I love your law. I hate and despise, sabi sa ibang salin, kinamumuhian ko ang mga kasinungalingan, ang mga kamalian. No? Very strong words that the psalmist used. No? Napaka mabigat na mga pananalita. At karapat-dapat lang. Kung ang allegiance natin as a word of God, anything that is against the word of God, dapat nating kamuhian. Tanong, do we hate and despise sin and falsehood as God does? Or do we treat it lightly and compromise with it? No? Ano ang ating allegiance to the word of God? Kapag nakikita natin mga bagay-bagay na kontra sa salita ng Diyos, okay lang ba? Pinababayaan lang ba natin? Ayos lang ba? Or do we feel that hurt just as God feels hurt? No? Kapag ang kanyang salita ay hindi tinataguyod. We must have the allegiance to the Word of God and feel that same intense passion for the Word of God and intense hatred for falsehood. Sabi ng isang manunulat, how often do we find ourselves simply overlooking the lies and deception of the enemy? No? Nagsasawa lang bahala tayo. We find ourselves acquiescing to the evil of the world. No? Parang okay lang, nakikibagay tayo kung ano ba yung tinataguyod ng mundo. For many of us, we have become numb to the evil intent and evil influence of this world. Pero ano ba ang dapat? The lies and deceptions of this world should sicken our hearts. Sin should always be something we hate. Yes, we do not hate the sinner, but we should hate the sin. Mabigat ang ating responsibility to uphold the Word of God against the falsehood all around us. At pang-apat, fourth way that we can demonstrate allegiance to the Word is to be consistent in upholding the Word. Be consistent. 7 times a day I praise you for your righteous laws. 7 times a day. Hindi naman siguro nagbibilang yung psalmist. The word, the number 7 is the number of perfection sa Bible. Ibig sabihin ng 7 times a day, palagi, lagi, always, lagi niyang pinupuri, lagi niyang itinataas ang katuwiran ng salita ng Diyos. Consistently doing it. Sabi nga ni Nay Bailey, an author, God's word is truer than anything I feel. Ang katotohanan ng salita ng Diyos hindi depende sa feeling natin. A feeling ko, tama yan eh. Hindi tayo sa feeling. Tama yan. Ano man ang feeling mo. God's word is truer than anything I experience. God's word is truer than any circumstance I will ever face. Consistently. Hindi depende sa feeling. Hindi depende sa, kasi ganito yung experience ko eh. Siguro mali ang sinasabi ng Bible. Iba sa experience ko eh. Ay, iba yung sitwasyon ko eh. Hindi nyo kasi naunawaan eh. Consistently. Demonstrate. Establish our allegiance to the Word of God. If we will experience true peace, we must uphold always the Word of God. Thirdly, letter A, we must acknowledge the source of peace. If you want to express yourself, if you want to reveal something about yourself, anong gagawin mo? Of course, you will use words. Sabihin mo yung bagay na gusto mong sabihin. But you can also use actions. Ipapakita mo. Actually, if you want to express yourself, you use both words and actions. Well, God has seen our condition. Alam ng Diyos yung ating pinagdaraanan. Alam ng Diyos yung brokenness sa ating buhay, sa mundo. And He has acted. He has spoken, and He has also acted. No, hindi lang salita, siya rin ay kumilos. Lahat ng mga pananampalataya dito sa mundo, iba't iba mga religion, they're all about man trying to reach God. But Christianity is different. Because in Christianity, God reached out to us. Ayaw natin makinig, hindi tayo nakikipag-usap sa Kanya, but God spoke to us through His Word. And not only through His Word, He spoke to us through the living Word. The Word who became flesh. We're familiar with that verse, the Word became flesh. Ang salita ay nagkatawang tao. Para maabot tayo ng Diyos, hindi lamang sa Kanyang spoken word which was written in the Bible, but by the Word who became flesh. Of course, we know the Word is Jesus Christ. Nagkatawang tao siya to speak to us so that God can heal our brokenness. God reaching out to us, reconciling us to Himself. Jesus gives peace. Sabi niya, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid." Ang Panginoon ang nagbibigay ng tunay na kapayapaan. Hindi katulad ng kapayapaan na binibigay ng mundo, which is mababaw na kapayapaan, false peace. Ang binibigay na kapayapaan ng ating Panginoon, lasting and true peace. This is divine peace na sa Kanya lang, siya lang ang makapagbibigay. Hindi peace na something that we can work up mula sa atin. Hindi peace na makukuha natin sa ibang tao. It is divine peace, a gift of God. In fact, it is a fruit of the Holy Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, and so on. Galing sa Diyos na kapayapaan. Hindi katulad ng kapayapaan na binibigay ng mundo. Many times in the Bible, our God, our Lord, is called the Lord of Peace. Paulit-ulit. Isang sample, 2 Thessalonians 3:16, "Now may the Lord of Peace Himself give you peace at all times and in every way." He gives peace. He is the Lord of Peace. Sabi niya sa kanyang mga alagad, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." Note the contrast. In the world and in me. In the world and in me. Saan ka? In the world, you will have trouble. In me, you will have peace. Jesus Christ is the source of peace. We must acknowledge Him. He gives peace. And not only does He give peace, our Lord Jesus Christ is peace Himself. Siya mismo yung fullness, ang pinaka-representation ng peace. In the same way that He has said, "I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life," He is also peace. Siya ang kapayapaan. Hindi lang siya nagbibigay ng kapayapaan, siya mismo ay kapayapaan. For He Himself is our peace. Sinabi ni Apostle Paul, He Himself, siya mismo, siya ang ating kapayapaan. The prophet Isaiah mentioned, the titles of the Messiah, different titles. The son who will be born, the coming Messiah, he will be Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Prinsipe ng kapayapaan. He is the Prince of Peace. I read the story of a missionary who was serving in a remote place. Noong unang panahon pa ito, he was serving among savages, noong mga pagans, mga taong mga nasa liblib na lugar, walang civilization, walang maayos na civilization, mga savages. And he was ministering in that place. Dumating doon sa point na merong matinding opposition. At siya ay gustong patayin ng mga miniministeran niya, mga savages. And they were running after him. Hinahabol siya. Gusto siyang patayin. Meron silang mga sibat at talagang siya ay papatayin. So siya ay tumatakbo, and then para makatakas siya, dumive siya doon sa ilog. Pagdive niya sa ilog, ano pa rin siya? Sinibat siya doon sa ilog. Buti na lang hindi siya tinamaan. After that experience, kinausap siya. Meron kumausap sa kanya. Ito yung tanong. What verse of the Bible ran through your mind nung ikaw ay hinahabol at muntik ka na nilang patayin? Anong salita ng Diyos ang tumakbo sa iyong isip? Sabi ng missionary, verse of the Bible? Word of God? Sabi niya, no. God Himself, Jesus Himself was with me. That's why I had peace. I was able to survive. More than the Word of God, peace Himself, the personification of peace Himself, our Lord Jesus Christ, in our lives, gives us peace. He is peace. Kaya nga meron tayong kanta, kasama natin ang Diyos. Dumaan man ako sa ilog, hindi ako malulunod. Dumaan man ako sa apoy, hindi ako masusunog. Kasama natin ang Diyos, hindi ako matatakot, hindi ako, sabi, mangangamba. No? So, it's because of Jesus Christ. He is peace. In me, you will have peace. He is the source of peace. Sabi ni Isaiah, you will keep in perfect peace him whose mind is steadfast. Sa ibang salin, him whose mind is stayed on you. Nakafocus sa kanya. Because he trusts in you. Because he trusts in you. Kasama natin ang Diyos. He is our peace. We must acknowledge the source of peace, our Lord Jesus Christ Himself, if we want to experience peace. Trusting God, trusting Him in the what ifs of life. No, marami tayo mga what ifs. Mga pangamba natin sa future. Di ba yung mga what if? What if magkasakit ako? What if bumagsak yung negosyo ko? What if matanggal ako sa trabaho? Yung lahat ng concern natin, what if yung asawa ko? But what if hindi ako makapag-asawa? What, lahat na ng mga what ifs na nagbumabag-habag sa atin, God is with us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. We can have peace. Trust Him not only in the what ifs of life. Trust Him in the if onlys of life. Kung yung what ifs focus dun sa future, yung mga if onlys focus naman sa nakaraan. Yung mga regret natin. Mga regret sa buhay na humahadlang sa ating buhay ngayon. At nawawala pa rin yung peace natin. We lose our peace because of this if onlys. If only ganito lang yung ginawa ko. If only dito ako nagtrabaho. If only siyang sinagot ko. If only itong napangasawa ko. If only, lahat ng mga if onlys, mga regrets sa buhay. We lose our peace because of these things that have happened in the past. Eh, nakaraan na yon. But trusting God, we know. Hawak naman niya yung buhay natin eh. Maging yung mga hindi magandang pangyayari sa ating buhay, Sabi niya, He is working all things together for good. Kaya yung mga if onlys, wala na yon. Hindi na natin mababalikan yun eh. Let's trust na pinayagan ng Diyos yon. He permitted that because He has a purpose. Meron siyang purpose sa ating buhay. Anong klaseng purpose? Purpose for our good. Purpose for our welfare, not for our calamity. Acknowledge the source of peace. Letter C, we must cultivate obedience to God's word. No? Pagsunod sa salita ng Diyos. I wait for your salvation, O Lord, and I follow your commands. I wait. I highlighted that word, wait. Kasi yung waiting niya, hindi yung waiting na nakatunga nga. Passive waiting. But anong klaseng waiting? While waiting, he follows the commands of God. Active waiting. Obedience. Following God's command. And then sinabi niya, I obey your statutes. No? Obedience. Bakit? For I love them greatly. I highlighted that word love because this is the motivation. The psalmist's motivation for obeying the word of God, hindi yung dahil sa, because it's an obligation. Because no choice siya. Because meron siyang mapapala. He obeys so that he can get something from God. Hindi. The motivation was and is love. Why does he obey? Because he loves the word of God and consequently, he loves God. Sabi nga ng ating Panginoon, if you love me, you will obey what I command. If you love me, you will obey what I command. Sabi pa niya sa ibang passage, and God's commandments are not burdensome. Hindi pahirap, hindi parusa ang mga utos ng Diyos. It is a blessing. We love God. We love to obey His commands. The psalmist also says, I obey your precepts and your statutes, for all my ways are known to you. Very conscious ang psalmist. Lahat ng sa buhay niya, lahat ng bagay sa buhay niya, maging kanyang iniisip, whatever he thinks, all the words that comes from his mouth, all his circumstances, everything he does, they are all known to God. Iba yung ano eh, iba yung feeling ng being known. In fact, nga daw sa relationship natin, yung talagang true relationship, it is to know others and to be known by others. Yun ang talagang tunay na relationship. And sa ating relationship sa God, to know God and to have that assurance that you are known by God. Lahat ng ating, hindi lang yung magaganda sa buhay natin. Maging yung mga hindi magaganda sa buhay natin, alam niya, and yet, He loves us. Yung transparency, the transparency that we have before God results in accountability to God. Because we know that we are transparent before God, wala tayong may tatago sa Kanya, then we are accountable to Him. Sabi ng psalmist, I obey your precepts, for all my ways are known to you. We must cultivate obedience to the Word of God. Holy Week na. Diba Holy Week na? And we will be remembering the suffering and the sacrifice of our Lord for us. Muli, mapapaalala sa atin all the hardships, the pain, the suffering that the Lord experienced for us. But haven't you noticed, in all these sufferings, when the Lord was being whipped, when the Lord was being crucified, when the Lord was being mocked, kinukutya ng mga tao, we notice the Lord calm and peaceful. Diba? We do not get any hint of nagwala siya o nagalit, gumante dun sa mga sumasakit sa kanya. There was that calmness and peace sa Panginoon. Even when confronting the high priest and Pilate himself, they were questioning him, they were accusing him. We see the movies. We read in the Word of God ang countenance ng ating Panginoon. Peace and calm. Bakit ganun ang ating Panginoon? Hindi kaya siya nahirapan? Of course, nahirapan siya. Hindi kaya siya nag-struggle? Nag-struggle siya. Ang pinakamatinding struggle ng ating Panginoon was in the Garden of Gethsemane. Alam niya mangyayari sa kanya. He knew what would happen. And alam niya na talagang the suffering that he will be experiencing. At sabi niya, if it is possible, let this cup pass away from me. But then there was that moment of decision. That pivotal moment of decision. But not my will, but yours be done. Obedience to the will of God. And from then on, wala na yung pag-agam-agam ng Panginoon. Natapos na yung prayer niya, kung pwede lang sana lumipas sa akin itong suffering na to. Wala na. He was completely calm and peaceful in the face of extreme suffering because he has decided, not my will, but yours be done. Obedience to God's word, obedience to God's will gave him that peace and sustained him through all his suffering. When we look at our Lord, talagang he really personified peace. And it's because he was submissive to the will of God. Meron tayong kinanta kanina eh. Di ba? Sabi na, kalimutan ko tuloy. Kanina inaalala ko eh. You have your way. Lord, yeah. Lord, have your way completely. Have your way in me completely. Something like that. No? Kinanta natin. No? Pero parang ganun, di ba? Have your way in me completely. Yung talagang obedience. Obedience to the Word of God. And fifthly, the letter E, expect God's blessing of peace. Great peace have they who love your law, and nothing can make them stumble. Those who love God's law, meaning those who love God who gave these laws, they have great peace. Nothing can make them stumble. Stumble means disaster. Stumble means giving in to temptation and falling into sin. Nothing can make them stumble. As we perceive our condition of brokenness, as we establish allegiance to the Word of God, as we acknowledge Jesus Christ as the source of our peace, as we cultivate obedience to His Word, we can expect God's peace. The brokenness, no? The opposite of shalom that we are experiencing in and around us can be restored by God, according to His promise and according to His working in our lives. We can expect the blessing of God's peace, which is the restoration of God's original design for relationships. Remember the emotional struggles that we have, the focus, the causes of all these problems and strife and conflict and wars and lack of stewardship. Yung lahat ng nasira sa ating relationship, sa ating sarili, sa tao, sa Diyos, at maging sa kalikasan, God can restore this. God can restore this. The pride can be turned to selflessness in the Lord. Guilt to forgiveness. The fear to trust in God. From shame to acceptance. From loneliness to true fellowship. From inferiority to God-given worth. And from anger to kind-heartedness. The Lord gives peace. The word of the Lord gives peace. Jesus Christ Himself is our peace. The shalom which was broken by sin because of our Lord Jesus Christ and according to His word can be restored. The brokenness can be healed, can be restored. And God is working. The process is already in place and will reach its completion in the day of our Lord when God makes everything perfect. But the process is already on the way because of the Lord Jesus Christ and because of His powerful words. Hindi ko alam kung ano ang pinagdadaanan ng bawat isa sa atin, but I'm sure marami tayong mga mabibigat na problema. Brokenness. Different kinds of brokenness in our lives. Sa ating sarili, sa ating pagtingin, sa ating sarili. And then sa ating kapwa. Broken relationships. Broken trust. No? Broken, yung mga dating mga maayos na samahan, nasisira. At tayo'y nananakit, at tayo ay nasasaktan. Brokenness in nature. Sinisira natin ang nature. Napakaganda ng mga kaloob sa atin ng Panginoon. Sinisira natin. Binabaliwala natin. Dahil hindi natin ina-appreciate. Kaguluhan, gera, torture, injustice, all around the world, all over the world, nangyayari. Where is the shalom? Where is the peace? God is working out His peace. Sabi niya, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. The peace of God. Not as the world gives, hindi yung peace ng mundo. The peace of God is a gift of God in Jesus Christ. Di malirip na kapayapaan, sabi sa Tagalog. A peace that transcends, passes all understanding. Babantayan ang ating mga puso, babantayan ang ating mga isipan. Hindi mawawala ang kaguluhan sa mundo. Hindi mawawala ang kaguluhan. Laging nandyan ang kaguluhan because yung brokenness ay nandyan pa. But in spite of this, kaguluhan in us, in our relationship with others and around the world, we can experience God's peace. Again, we sang this very meaningful song. When the oceans rise and the thunders roar, no? I will soar with you above the storm. You are King. Lord, you are King over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. Hindi tinanggal yung storm. Nandiyan pa rin ang storm. Nandiyan pa rin yung alon ng ocean. Nandiyan pa rin yung mga kulog. But we can soar. Hindi tinanggal ng Lord, but we can soar above these things because God is there. We can be still and know that He is God. In one line of another song, it says, sometimes God calms the storm. Yes, sometimes God tinatanggal yung gulo. But not all the time. Other times, He calms His child. No? Andyan ang kaguluhan, nandyan ang bagyo, at tayo nasa gitna ng bagyo, but in Christ, we can have His peace. And His word proclaims that peace. The Word gives peace. The living Word, the Word became flesh, gives peace. peace. He is our peace. Lord, maraming salamat. You are the Lord of peace, Lord. At sa kaguluhan na aming mga na-experience sa buhay, sa kahirapan ng buhay, within us, Lord, sa sarili namin, sa aming relationship, sa aming kapwa, maging sa aming relationship sa yung the rest of your creation, Lord, sometimes we can be discouraged. We are oftentimes frustrated. But your word encourages us, Lord. Nagbibigay ng kalakasan sa amin. Because we know that you give peace. Your word gives peace. You are our peace, Panginoon. Ano man ang nangyayari sa aming mga buhay, ano man ang mga pinagdadaanan ng bawat isa sa amin, Panginoon, mabibigat na problema, mga problema na hindi namin alam ang solusyon, problems that overwhelm us, things around us, Lord God, that make us weep, observing the suffering of our people, the suffering of other people all over the world. Lord, we can be still. We can be calm in the midst of the storm because you are there and your word speaks to us. Thank you so much, Lord. Thank you so much. Thank you for your promise that you will never leave us nor forsake us. Thank you, Lord God, that even though dumaan man kami sa apoy, dumaan man kami sa tubig, Lord God, kasama namin kayo, wala kaming dapat alalahanin. Maraming salamat for your love, your protection, and your gift of peace. We give you the glory and the honor. In Jesus' name, Amen.